With Microsoft Learn, you learn by doing, with interactive step-by-step tutorials creating real resources in Azure. Even better, it's free and no credit card is required. Dan is here to show us how, today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Dan and we're going to learn all about Microsoft Learn. So tell me, what is this Microsoft Learn?
So Microsoft Learn is a free way for you to learn Azure, Power Apps, Power BI, Dynamics, and other Microsoft products and services.
Okay, so it's a series of tutorials, is it testing? I mean, how do I learn?
All of the above.
Okay.
So one of the key things we want to do is provide a guided path for people who are, say, new to Azure. What are the things I need to do to understand the fundamentals, what is Azure, and walk through and interactively build and create and manage Azure resources all for free.
All right, so I think that's the part that makes it different than just reading a tutorial. I'm not responsible for creating an Azure account and then following the steps in my own Azure account. I can actually build these resources, actual fire up a VM or an app service, but I'm not being charged for it because it's part of learning this particular thing.
Yeah, so we give you fixed time resources. So, okay. You know, you're learning Cosmos DB. How do I create a Cosmos DB or an Azure App Service and so on? And then we walk you through step by step. You're doing everything in the browser, including writing code, writing commands for PowerShell or Azure CLI or directly in the Azure portal. And you can even use your local developer tools. So we unlock that free account and you get access for fixed time, let's say 2 hours, where I can complete that Cosmos DB tutorial using that free account.
Ah, okay, so there's a lot of cool features inside of Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code where I can actually connect to my Azure subscription and do things. So you're saying even with this account that I get as part of the docs, I
right.
can do those same tutorials and finish them.
Exactly, learn your way.
Gotcha, awesome. So can you show me how it works?
Yeah, so first thing here, we are at the Microsoft Learn homepage. So this gives you a number of things for learning paths, hands-on learning, and just gives you a product and overview. And you can see some of the content that we have here for learning Azure and some of the different tutorials, including our partners like Pluralsight, LinkedIn Learning, and some of the Azure certifications. What I want to do, though, is first show you how you can see all of the content that we have. In fact, we have over 80 hours of learning content available in 17 languages for Azure and 23 for Dynamics and Power BI.
Gotcha. But no, we kind of started on that first page, but this is nestled inside of Docs, right?
Yes, this is all part of Docs. So using the same engine, all the wonderful tools that we know and love for GitHub as well.
So if I go to docs.com, I will be able to find my way into Learn.
Exactly.
Okay, got it. Okay, so I wanted to make sure.
So the first thing that we see here is, let's just do a search for, say, Azure. And what we'll see is the results, and we see 73 results for Azure, and you see something called a learning path. If you're new to Azure, we'll click on Azure Fundamentals. We see we have a set of tags and gamification as well.
Cool.
In terms, and you see that I've done this before. So this goes into Intro to Azure. What are the things that I'm gonna do? Where it explains, what is Azure? How do you scale something up? How do you create a virtual machine? Or principles of cloud computing. What is cloud computing? What are the different models in cloud services? And really, this is a guided path for hours that takes you through your first set of experience using compute, using storage, using networking, and using and adding security.
Yeah, it's interesting that you've gamified this, because sometimes I won't do things, but now that I can be better at it than you can do it, and I can actually have proof, that makes it more fun. So I'm going to learn stuff about Azure I probably had no interest in, just so that I have more points than someone else doing it. So
yes,
very cool.
Absolutely. So I'm going to go ahead and click back and show just another quick search here. Let's search for, and instead of actually doing a search, let's show some of the different ways that you can filter, where you just want to see things for developer, right? Or you want to see beginner intermediate content, or by product. So in this case, let's search for a specific product and say container instances, and I see the three things around container instances. And what I'll do is take you to this module. So in about 50 minutes, we're going to go from having nothing, knowing nothing about Azure Container Instances to having something running directly in the cloud.
Gotcha.
So this is a module. It explains the different areas that we have. Because I've completed it, it even shows the time remaining. So we really want to be thoughtful of how much time you're spending. So you can see, like, hey, this step takes 7 minutes, this one takes 15. So you can plan your lunches better.
Sure, exactly.
So I'm going to go specifically into, let's do the introduction to Azure Container Instances, and we'll start looking at the actual content. So we're within the content. This one takes 2 minutes. And you see the learning objectives. And let's just get started. So what you see here is the Azure Cloud Shell, and it's activating what's called a sandbox.
Okay.
So I have logged in before. I am logged in to my account. We use organizational ID or Microsoft accounts.
Okay.
So what this is doing is it's now giving me access to basically my sandbox. So I, instead of, you know, you using your account where your production environments are working, accidentally deleting the VMs, this sandbox, you know, it goes away after a couple hours. So that way you make sure you don't break the wrong things.
Gotcha.
So and it's safe. You can.
And it also sounds like then if it's going to go away in a couple of hours, I probably want to sit down and try to complete one of these entire learning paths before that subscription gets recycled, right? Because I wouldn't potentially be able to come back a week from now and finish this, right?
Yeah, well, it depends on the step, right? So long as you kind of finish the steps, you can jump back in. And in some cases, we're looking to make that a little easier.
Okay.
So you can actually say clone and start from a certain step.
Gotcha.
But yeah, just in general, it really depends on what thing. If it's something that builds on the others, yeah, you should probably do it in one sitting.
Okay.
But we try to design it as atomically as possible.
Oh, very cool.
Okay, so we're within here. And this gives me information even why I'd want to use Azure Container instances, what it is, and what regions I can create it. And I'm going to do a couple things. I'm just going to start. This is a live Azure Cloud Shell, which lets us run commands. And I'm just going to copy paste here. And what it's going to do is create a DNS label name for me. And I'm going to click copy. And this is actually going to create a container for me. And let's do West US 2. And you saw the list of regions that were available before. I'll click Enter. And what this is actually going to do is, remember, we're creating real live services directly in Azure. So as we go kind of step by step, this is the resource group that we're running against. We see the values. And what we're going to do is, once this is done running, we're going to use the Azure Container Show to show the finished container that we just created.
All right. So we'll get an IP address that we can actually use to hit this actual ACI image. So right now it looks like it's going to be running a Hello World image inside of this ACI instance, correct?
Yeah, so just a couple things that the docs walk through, like what is the name of it, what is the image, and we see that it's actually returned within here. So the DNS label and what port to hit.
Yeah, we can, yep.
Let's try and just copy this, and because we're doing output to a table, we'll see a nice preview of that. And that's what we did. We did the provisioning state,
oh, wow,
and that fully qualified domain name. And now what I'm going to do is copy paste.
That.
This is the hardest part of the demo. I'm going to click here, open a new tab, and click run. And there we see it live directly there. So within just a few minutes,
sure,
I was able to use free Azure resources, be able to build an Azure Container instances, run, make sure that it actually works. But wait, there's more. So one of the things we wanted to do is do that gamification. So at the very end of this is the check your work button. So what this is going to do is, a lot of times you for learning, we have these things called knowledge check, which are multiple choice quizzes, if you will. But it's really focused not so much on getting it right or wrong, where you're worried about Googling the answer, but about learning. So
sure,
if you do get it wrong, we'll show you like, hey, here's the reasons it was this option versus this option.
Gotcha.
You're not like kind of penalized where you're worried about getting it wrong. It really is about learning and retaining the information, which is why we call it knowledge check instead of a quiz.
Gotcha.
So let's click check your work. This is going to walk up to my account, make sure that I actually have the right properties. So using Azure Resource Manager, did they create the container instance,
gotcha,
correctly? Did they use the right image? Is it actually the successful deployment? If it is, think of it as like unit tests. Yes, then you get the unlocked achievement.
So I can't just go down to the bottom on this page and click that button if I hadn't run through the steps.
Yes, absolutely. And with a number of these specific achievements, the only way to unlock it is that we know you've done that deployment.
Oh, very cool.
Yes, absolutely. So let's talk about that just a little. If we go to our profile page, and maybe I'll just jump to here since we have it loaded already, we see my profile. I'm level 6, so you have a little bit of catching up to do. Badges earned, and all the different badges that you have within your content. And of course, you can share these on Facebook. So, and this is really our unified user profile, where we're looking to add more information about how you use kind of our forums or our documentation or our learning experiences. And you can share them to, say, Facebook, to Twitter, or, of course, LinkedIn, or
gotcha,
via email.
Gotcha. So is there like a leaderboard coming yet? Because that would be a cool feature. Because I need to know how much I got to beat you by, and I want to be able to humiliate you with it. So how is that coming?
Yeah, so one of the things that we asked you, and we just unveiled this last month in September, where folks were asking for organizational leaderboards.
Absolutely.
Or how do we do leaderboards in the right way where you can maybe invite your team?
Sure.
And then it's like your study group, right?
Right.
So one of the biggest motivations is seeing that notification, hey, Donovan completed the training, you haven't. And that way, sometimes with leaderboards, you may not care about everybody doing it, but you really, really care if it's your team or
Absolutely.
Your organization. So those are things we're definitely looking at for the future, and we'd love your feedback as
well. Yeah, I think leaderboards are crucially important. I remember when a friend of mine got a Fitbit, and I was like, oh, what, that's stupid. And then he showed me a leaderboard. I'm like, what, I can beat you at being fit?
Yes.
And then I ran out and I bought a Fitbit immediately just so that I could be higher than him on the leaderboard. So tapping into that competitive drive of a lot of us, I think,
Absolutely.
Is going to be awesome. So
Absolutely.
This is really, really cool stuff.
So again, all the content's available for free, 17 languages global, 80 hours of content. Play with it. Let us know what you think.
Absolutely. No credit card to get started, but
no,
you're
credit
actually
card
working
required.
On real stuff. Awesome. We are learning all about Microsoft Learn here on Azure Friday.